And today we are going to be doing makeup.
Falling through a roof of an abandoned building. 14-year-old Milo Johnston died last night in Leeds, the latest youngster to come to harm after a series of similar incidents.
So I am going to what happened?
The holidays,
we've got he fell through a roof.
What, an abandoned?
And
it's the weekend, so I'll have the all important weather forecast.
Hi, and about that little lad.
First tonight, a family has been left devastated after their 14-year-old son fell more than 30 feet to his death through the skylight of a derelict building.
Milo Johnston was playing with a group of friends in a disused warehouse in Leeds when tragedy struck last night.
Now police have issued an urgent warning about the dangers of clambering onto disused buildings. As they revealed, Milo's death is the third incident where youngsters in the city have come to serious harm in as many months, John Hill reports.
So that's fun.
Described as funny and one in a million, Milo Johnston paid for a moment of mischief with his life. Flowers have been left today by his family. They're from the Bramley area of Leeds, a couple of miles from the abandoned warehouse at Canal Wharf, where Milo met his death last night. It's thought Milo had climbed onto the roof of this building. This is the plastic skylight he fell through. There were frantic efforts by his friends to help him, but there was nothing they, or paramedics, could do.
What we think has happened is that Milo's been with a group of friends, and he's climbed onto the roof, and obviously they've gone exploring, and unfortunately, tragically, Milo's fallen through the roof. The family are absolutely devastated, and also, you know, he's a brother. You know, he's got brothers and sisters at home, so the impact is not only felt within the police community, but also the local community, but also his family are absolutely distraught.
Milo's death follows two similar recent incidents in Leeds, where two boys were seriously injured in falls at disused buildings. A 12-year-old boy was seriously hurt at a derelict factory in Modder Avenue in Armley on June the 20th, and a 13-year-old boy was seriously injured at a derelict building in Ninelands Lane in Garforth on May the 28th.
The warning for us is stay away from these disused sites. Yes, they might be interesting. Yes, you know, it's mischievous. We're coming up to summer holidays, we've got light nights, but they're death traps. You know, we've got to stay away. We don't only have a responsibility for ourselves and me as police officers, but
next
parents and the school community and the children themselves have the same responsibility.
Are you just sure on me?
I don't
want to be abusing our mistake.
Tonight, contractors have been called in to try and secure the site. The barriers may act as a deterrent, but police say the shocking death of a young boy and grave injuries to two others in a matter of weeks should serve as a potent warning. Stay away.
Yeah,
so, John,
as
you say, efforts have been made to secure tonight.
Well, there's been a steady stream of Milo's friends coming to lay flowers, and I'm supposed to share them.
Can you not see that?
We don't know how Milo and the other youngsters actually got onto the site, but the main gates here have now been closed. They've been padlocked. It's a grave tragedy, clearly, and there have been two very other serious injuries, as we've heard in previous weeks. I suppose police are hoping that the only lesson, the only positive, if you like, that can be drawn from this, is that this must serve as a salutary lesson to youngsters and to schools as well.
I don't know.
The lesson, the warning, is these places simply are not playgrounds. They are death traps.
Thank you for us this evening in Leeds. Now, 3 days of disruption on the rail network will begin tomorrow morning as some workers stage a strike over plans for driver-only trains.
Most Northern Rail routes will be affected as RMT union members say they have concerns about the safety of train services if there's only one member of staff on board.
But Northern Rail is urging the union to get back around the table for more talks. Adam Fowler reports.
I've been to Wembley.
The 1024 from Sheffield to Doncaster.
Rovers won the blade.
Northern Rail services
Bradford
will
Northern
be affected by industrial action
and
then
won the
next
play,
few
in
years. On Monday, this service won't operate at all. The train
operator
Northern wants to move towards driver-only trains. It says it wants to modernise the service. But the union is concerned about rail safety. And it's the passengers.
Your mum will be ringing soon.
In the middle. These
were
going on the weekend away.
So far, for watching.
I've not even checked the timings. I didn't even know it was on. So,
That's messages about a potential service where the driver of the train is the only member of staff on board.
The tickets and who's getting on without paying and stuff like that, you know. Plus it's, I think it's a health and safety issue as well, isn't it?
Thanks for watching. Bye.